The controversial high-speed rail project is on hold tonight. Supporters stopped it, catching a lot of people off guard. 12 News' Brendan Conway is live in downtown Milwaukee, and you just spoke to Governor-elect Scott Walker, who was also surprised.
Yeah, Kathy, this rail project just seemed like it was a done deal over the weekend. The state, kind of behind closed doors, finalized plans to get this project going, to spend that $810 million in federal stimulus money. But then today, without warning, current Governor Jim Doyle put on the brakes.
We feel confident we could stop the train. We just didn't know the action would come this quickly.
Governor-elect Scott Walker ran on a platform of stopping the train, but he had no idea it would happen just days after he was elected. In a move that caught nearly everyone off guard, Governor Doyle ordered all work on the train temporarily stopped. In a statement, State DOT Secretary Frank Busalacci says, in light of the election results, our agency will be taking a few days to assess the real-world consequences, including the immediate impacts to people and their livelihoods, if this project were to be stopped. The head of the Wisconsin Transportation Builders Association says the delay puts dozens of workers in limbo. The state Democratic Party says shutting it down for good would cost thousands of jobs.
Long term, our goal is to spend that money fixing roads and bridges, so there's going to be a lot of jobs connected with that as well.
In Milwaukee, the shutdown could have an extra impact. Spanish train company Talgo recently moved into the old Tower Automotive site. They are hiring 125 workers to build trains. The city spent $3 million fixing up the tower site with the understanding Talgo would be around for years. Mayor Barrett says if that changes, they may take legal action.
Well, we'll be talking to our city attorney to see if we have any recourse if this ends.
And Governor-elect Walker says he will meet next week with Governor Doyle, and at that point he could have a better sense of whether or not this is just a temporary shutdown or if it may in fact be the beginning of the end of this rail line. Reporting live in downtown Milwaukee, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.